Did you know that almost all the food products that you get from the market have added chemicals in them? And then you might assume that, well, they are tested and approved by authorities, they must be okay for me, right? Well, sorry to say, but you are wrong. Hello everyone, welcome to Target 100 Years, where you get your health information which is backed by research and vetted by experts. In this video, you will get answers to these 5 questions related to various food additives and chemicals which you consume daily without even knowing about them. What are the different types of chemicals that are added to your food? How do you know about the chemical that has been added? How are these chemicals tested to be fit for human consumption? What are the most common harmful effects of eating food additives? How to deal with food additive sensitivity? For this video, we would like to thank Ms. Emmy Grace, who is a master's in nutrition and specializes in pregnancy-related diet. So without any delay, let's get started. Starting off with the first question, which are the different type of chemicals that get added to your food? Any chemical which helps in keeping food fresh without going stale, or which enhances the properties like texture, color, cochineal or tartrazine, or flavor, MSG, monosodium glutamate of that food are considered to be food additives. There are many food additives used in the food industry. Let's take a look at top 20 of them, along with their role or purpose for being added in the food. Number one is anti-caking agents, which are used to prevent ingredients like flour from forming lumps. Antioxidants, they prevent rancidity, that is oxidation of fats that leads to stale food, or oxidation resulting in unpleasant color change as in cut apple pieces exposed to air. Artificial sweeteners, they enhance the sweetness of the food. Emulsifiers, they prevent clotting of the fats together. Food acids, they are used to maintain the right acidity levels in the food. Color, as the name suggests, they are used to add or improvise already present color in the food. Humectants, they help in keeping foods moist. Flavors, addition of any flavors like fruit flavors for ice creams. Flavor enhancers, they strengthen the effect of flavor in the food. Foaming agents, they help in incorporating air uniformly inside a food like cake batters. Mineral salts, they elevate the flavor and texture. Preservatives, they are used to prevent the multiplication of microbes and also prevent food spoilage. Thickeners and vegetable gums, they stabilize the consistency and texture of the food. Stabilizers and firming agents, they keep the food evenly dispersed. Flour treatment, improve quality of baking. Glazing agents, they are used to enhance appearance and protect food. Gelling agents, they enable gel formation and improve texture of certain foods like jelly. Propellants, enable a food to propel from a container. Raising agents, they aid in increasing the volume of food through mixing in gases, for example flour batters. Bulking agents, they increase the volume with alteration in energy content of the food. Moving on to how do you get to know about chemicals in your food? With so many chemicals in your food, is it difficult to find them in the food product? Not actually. Thanks to the government regulations, you can find most of the chemicals clearly listed on the food labels along with other ingredients. The norm for arranging ingredients in a food product is through descending order of the quantity, that is weight, in that product. Which means that the first item in the list has maximum percentage by weight and the last item has the minimum. Flavors are given an exception where they are not required to be revealed in the food labels. Mostly, the food additives are assigned a code number, like for coloring, 120 is for cochineal and preservative, 221 for sodium sulfite, rather than specifying their entire name, which actually is noticed in rare cases. As a consumer, it is confusing to understand what these codes really mean without spending some time to research. On the contrary, many people may also have this misconception that processed food will definitely have an added chemical. But certain foods like extended shelf milk, frozen and canned food are all processed without any necessity to add extra chemicals. When unsure about the presence of food additives, it is always recommended to check food labels where ingredients would be listed. However, you may still not find margarine on the back cover, which itself is a food additive. Next up is, how are food additives tested to be fit for human consumption? Not surprisingly, animals are usually used as a medium to test food additives before approval for human consumption. A series of toxicological tests are carried out to determine the dose or quantity of a particular additive, which is safe limit, and beyond which it would cause harmful effects on the health. If the approving body has any discrepancy on any additive, then they don't approve that for human consumption. In case a food additive has been approved and was later found to be harmful with scientific evidence and research, then that food additive will be banned for human consumption. Each food additive is tested individually to know its exact effects on health rather than in combination of additives together. Therefore, the side effects of consumption of a mixture of many food additives are unknown in the longer run. Let us now understand what can be the harmful effects of food additives. For many people, food additives may not be harmful in the short run, but a few of currently approved food additives were found to be linked to adverse health conditions in future. Certain hypersensitive reactions include digestive disorder, which may include colicky pain and diarrhea, nervous disorder, which may lead to insomnia, irritability, and hyperactivity, respiratory problems, which may have sinusitis, asthma, and rhinitis, skin problem, rashes and hives, swelling on skin and itching. Proper diagnosis of this allergic response must be confirmed through certain sensitivity tests. This will confirm the allergic response is from which food. Common food additives that are causing problems are, number 1, flavor enhancers, which includes MSG 621, food coloring, which may be Tartazine 102, Sunset Yellow FCF 110, Cochineal 120, Yellow 2G 107. Preservatives. Some preservatives that may be causing problem are sulfites 220, 221, 222, 223, 224, 225, and 228. Benzoates 210, 211, 212, 213. Nitrates 249, 250, 251, and 252. In addition, artificial sweeteners may also be causing problems. One of them may be aspartame 951. Though allergy is not common for food additives, there are certain people who experience allergic symptoms when consuming certain additives like hives, which include rashes on the skin, anywhere on the body, or diarrhea. Food additives during pregnancy and lactation. Many food additives which were found to be having adverse effects on growth and development of the babies, their hormonal balance, especially when consumed by pregnant and lactating mothers. A few chemicals which are recommended to be avoided during pregnancy and lactation are biphenols, mostly found in plastic bottles, bags and cans. Phthalates, also found in plastics. Perfluoroalkyl chemicals, also known as PFCs. These are found in cardboard and fast food packaging, microwave, popcorn, and non-stick pots and pans. Percolate, they are found in dry packed foods like rice, cereals for babies. Artificial food colorings, found in certain drinks, sweets and candies. Nitrates or nitrites, found in processed and cured meats. Those having food allergies or intolerances are more prone to be sensitive to these chemical additives, which occur naturally in some foods like shellfish and nuts. Many consumers have a view that food additives are a major food threat. However, when compared for health effects, food additives in some cases may cause less harm in foodborne illness caused due to microorganisms like salmonella, environmental contaminants, unsafe eating habits, inappropriate hygiene, and toxins which occur naturally. But avoiding food additives is practically not possible, as almost all packaged foods contain these chemicals. Certain food additives are even from natural source, like monosodium glutamate (MSG), which naturally occurs in Parmesan cheese, tomato, and sardines. Now, how do you deal with food additive sensitivity? food additive sensitivity does not have a different set of symptoms, but it is same as many other disorders. Therefore, consulting a doctor is very important. The process would mostly be to keep a personal food diary, where you are required to note down all the food items that you consume throughout a day, and also to keep track of any adverse symptoms or effects after consumption of those food. If a suspect food additive is noted, then all the food containing that additive are to be completely avoided to prevent any further health complications. If there were a group of additives which led to sensitive reactions, then all those foods are eliminated from the diet and are reintroduced one by one into the diet to be more precise on which is the culprit additive that has caused sensitive reaction to that individual. This is suggested to be done under medical supervision, as some symptoms like asthma could be serious. To summarize, what we covered in this video are: food additives are chemicals or natural elements that are used to enhance and prevent spoilage of food. It can cause sensitivity in certain people with adverse health complications and certain symptoms which could become worse if not treated at proper time. Food additives can usually be found listed in the ingredient section of the food label through the entire name or code number. Many food additives are approved as safe for human consumption with various functional properties in the food in which they are added. Food elimination and reintroduction process can be done to avoid potential sensitivity causing food additives with medical supervision and prescription. Pregnant and lactating mothers are advised to be more cautious in consuming certain food items which have chemicals in them, and it is best for them to avoid storing food in plastics. If you want to see another video explaining more about these food additives or chemicals or any health related topic, please mention that in the comment section below. Do subscribe and press the bell icon to get notification for research-based and expert-backed videos. Thank you so much for watching this.